Hello, this is Math 2231 coming to you from the College of DuPage for summer 2020. And this lecture is called 22314. And this is some common headline notions. The syllabus is here. You should read it and ask questions as necessary. Secure your textbook. Watch all the videos mentioned in the announcement. Read the review sections of your textbook. Here they are shown here. Here's an additional trig reference for you as well. Begin the review quiz that is due on Friday, which is 6-5, and this is in your syllabus tab. Begin the critical thinking quiz that is due on Thursday, 6-4. This is embedded in this video lecture. Start using the support services that are available, John and the entire MAA, Jesse and the entire tutoring shop, and me and my office hours, and I also am reachable through the math assistance area. Details later about how you submit your quizzes, but your work should begin happening immediately. Calculus is the study of limits, so we begin discussing this notion immediately with a story and an assignment. Zeno was a philosopher, and he frustrated a lot of the mathematicians of the day because he would pose questions that they couldn't answer, including this paradox. So this is called Zeno's Paradox of the Tortoise and Achilles. Okay, so so he's perhaps best known for this paradox of the tortoise and Achilles. It inspired many thinkers, Lewis Carroll, who wrote Alice in Wonderland, and Douglas Hofstadter, who is a major researcher at the university. The original goes like this. The tortoise challenged Achilles to a race, claiming that he would win as long as Achilles gave him a small head start. Achilles laughed at this, for of course he was a mighty warrior and swift of foot, whereas the tortoise was slow and heavy. How big a head start do you need? He asked the tortoise with a smile. 10 meters, the latter replied. Achilles laughed louder than ever. You will surely lose, my friend, in that case, but let us race if you wish. On the contrary, said the tortoise, I will win, and I can prove it to you by a simple argument. Go on then, Achilles replied, with less confidence he had felt before, because he knew he was a superior athlete, but he also knew the tortoise had sharper wits, and he'd lost many bewildering arguments with him before. Suppose, began the tortoise, that you give me a 10-meter head start. Would you say you would cover that 10 meters between us very quickly? Very quickly, Achilles affirmed. And in that time, how far should I have gone, do you think? Perhaps a meter, no more, said Achilles after a moment's thought. Very well. So now there is a meter between us, and you would catch up that distance very quickly indeed, said Achilles. And yet, in that time, this is the turtle talking, or the tortoise talking, and yet in that time I have sure gone a little way further, so that now you must catch that distance up. Yes, yes, said Achilles slowly, and while you're doing so, I have sure gone a little further, and so you must catch up that new distance, the tortoise continued smoothly. Achilles said nothing. And so you see, in each moment you will be catching up with the distance between us, and yet I, at the same time, will be adding a new distance, however small, for you to catch up again. Indeed, it must be so, said Achilles wearily. And so you can never catch up, the tortoise concluded sympathetically. You're right, as always, said Achilles sadly, and conceded the race. Now, even though mathematicians of the day were baffled, I give you some additional information, this actually can be posed as a word problem appropriate for today's high school algebra. Suppose that the tortoise has an average speed of 1 meter per second, and Achilles has an average speed of 10 meters per second, and it gives the tortoise a 10-meter head start. Question 1. How long does it take Achilles to catch up to the tortoise using high school algebra? Question 2, which is an essay and somewhat more involved and worth more points, reconcile your answer in question 1 with the problem as posed in Zeno's Paradox, because you see, in Zeno's Paradox, he never caught up. And certainly you don't have the number that's here. So reconciling includes reconciling not only that he caught up, but also the number. This quiz is to be submitted on Thursday, June 4th. Now, success in calculus depends critically on prerequisite skills. The balance of this lecture begins that review. It's certainly not everything, but it foretells the possibility of needing to cover many math skills from your past. Part A is algebra, part B is analytic geometry, part C is functions, and part D is trigonometry. Here are some sample problems. Here's a problem that is from part A, and this is problem 1, part F. And so you know what to do when I show you. You're supposed to work the problem. And then after you pause the video, you work the problem. And then you come back to see if you got it right. This is 16 to the minus 3/4. Let's see how you did. You should have gotten 1 over 8. This next problem is problem number 2, and I do expect you to submit these answers as well, but if you work through them here, you understand them and have the answers there. If you don't understand some of these, you should get help. You want to simplify each expression. This is the square root of 200 minus the square root of 32. You know what to do. Let's see how you did. The answer should have been 6 square root of 2. Here's the third set of problems. Let's talk about part E. That is x plus 2 whole cubed. You know what to do. Let's see how you did. You should have gotten x cubed plus 6x squared plus 12x plus 8. This is question 4, part C. You were to factor this expression that you see here. You know what to do. Let's see how you did. So you factor this using the factor by grouping. I actually changed the problem a little bit. I set it equal to 0 because it's a more interesting problem is solving this set equal to 0. So the factorization is up here, but if you're solving this equal to 0, you set each factor in turn equal to 0, and these are the solutions to my revised problem. Here's problem number 7. It's about completing the square, and I do problem A. You know what to do. Let's see how you did. And there is your answer. Question 8, and we're going to talk about G. You're supposed to solve this equation. This actually comes up a lot whenever you're solving equations dealing with derivatives. So what you need to do is you need to solve this equal to 0. You know what to do. Let's see how you did. So you have to factor carefully and set the numerator equal to 0, and you get x is 12 over 5. Here's problem number 9. You solve this inequality. I'm doing part A. Let's see how you did. In interval notation, you should have written bracket minus 13 over 3, comma 8 over 3, parentheses. And here now we are to the benediction for the today. Now more than ever, time is precious. Each day must count. Do the math, it will make you strong. And now more than ever, take care of yourself and of each other. May God bless you and yours.